Hello everybody, and welcome to Theology 101. In the previous video, we learned how God is spirit and the four implications of that truth. In case you missed it, I'll leave a link for you to watch above. Today we are going to talk about how God is holy and how we are to be holy. First, let me define the word holy. Holy means that God is set apart from us. If we are imperfect, then God is perfect. If we make mistakes, then God doesn't make mistakes. God is unlike us in that he is completely without sin. When the prophet Isaiah saw a vision of God, he saw angels around his throne saying this, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." The angels were worshiping God for being holy or set apart from us. This is why Isaiah responds to his vision by saying that he is a man with unclean lips, because he just witnessed God's holiness compared to his sinfulness. Now, throughout the Old Testament, God's holiness is often connected to his righteousness and justice. Righteousness typically refers to a person fulfilling his or her relational obligation to other people. So God's righteousness means that he always lives up to the promises that he makes with us. Justice is a legal term that is used in the courtroom. It typically refers to social righteousness. Whereas righteousness is primarily expressed in private relationships, justice is expressed in the public arena. And God's justice is mainly seen in the laws that he gives to his people, because his laws are a reflection of his holiness, which is why God often tells his people to obey his laws of justice, because he is a holy God. So since God is holy, his holiness demands personal righteousness and public justice. Now, what makes God different or set apart from us is that he does not need an outside standard to follow. God himself is the standard. For example, we need to implement laws in our country for people to follow. We need laws to demonstrate what we consider to be righteous or just. In a family, the parents set house rules for the children to follow according to what they consider righteous or just. But God does not need an outside standard to inform him of what is righteous or just. He himself is the standard. Look at how God describes himself in regards to righteousness and justice. "And I will make justice the line, and righteousness the plumb line." Do you know what a plumb line is? A plumb line is a weight suspended from a string so that the law of gravity will center the weight until the string becomes an exact vertical. Painters and carpenters often use a plumb line to keep their work straight. God says that his standard of righteousness and justice is the plumb line by which everyone else must follow. God's holiness, therefore, explains why he must judge sin. God will no longer be holy if he tolerated anything unrighteous or unjust. It goes against his very nature. Do you remember the story when Abraham appealed to God to not destroy Sodom and Gomorrah? This is what he said, "Far be it from you to do such a thing, to put the righteous to death with the wicked, so that the righteous fare as the wicked. Far be that from you. Shall not the judge of all the earth do what is just?" Abraham appeals to God's character. He appeals to his holiness. And based on God's holiness, Abraham knows that God would never kill righteous people along with the unrighteous. So he tells God that he cannot destroy Sodom and Gomorrah for the sake of the righteous. God agrees with Abraham. And he says that if Abraham could even find just 10 righteous people, he won't destroy the cities. But we know that God ultimately did destroy Sodom and Gomorrah because there weren't any righteous people in that city. And God's holiness means that he cannot overlook sin or overlook anything that is unrighteous. God's holiness is a reason why God the Father had to judge Jesus on the cross. Look at how Paul explains this. "This was to show God's righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he had passed over former sins. It was to show his righteousness at the present time so that he might be just and the justifier of the one who has faith in Jesus." Even though God's people offered animal sacrifices over many years, these animal sacrifices could not take away sin permanently. So God has to send a perfect, unblemished sacrifice, namely Jesus, in order to atone for the sins of his people. And when Jesus died on the cross, his blood paid the penalty for our sin so that God's holiness and his justice would not be compromised. Now, why does knowing how God's holiness is connected to justice and righteousness matter for us? The Apostle Peter tells us, "But as he who called you is holy, you also be holy in all your conduct, since it is written, 'You shall be holy, for I am holy.'" Since God is holy, he expects his people to live holy lives. But if we don't understand what it means that God is holy, then we don't understand what it looks like to live holy lives. This means that we are to live our lives according to God's standard of justice and righteousness. We don't overlook injustice in this world. We hunger and thirst after justice and righteousness as Jesus preached. We conduct our lives with honor in this world so that people will see our deeds and glorify God. Now you might be thinking, how can God expect us to be holy like Him? We are unlike God. Good question. There's a second way to understand holiness. Holiness means to be set apart from what is common. It doesn't mean that something is perfect without any sin, but it means that something is set apart from the common things for a special purpose. Have you ever wondered how God can declare a certain day to be holy? How can days be holy? Days are amoral. There's nothing immoral or moral about a certain day. It wasn't as if all the days got together and compared themselves to one another. Monday, you are so depressing with your blues. Friday, you party way too much. Tuesday, too many people drink with tacos on your day. Saturday, Sabbath, you are the holy one. So why did God declare that Saturday or the Sabbath was a holy day? It was because of the second understanding of the word holy. It was because Saturday or the Sabbath, it was set apart from what was common. This is why God calls certain cups or utensils holy, because these cups and utensils were set apart from the common cups and utensils that was used. It is like the special china in my mom's cabinet. It's holy. We can't use it unless the president comes over for dinner one day. And so when God calls us to be holy, He knows that we can't be holy like Him in being sinless. It's impossible for us to not sin. He's calling us to be set apart from the world and to live with His standard of righteousness and justice, even if it doesn't match with the world's standard of righteousness and justice. You see, all of us know that a pencil is a very common item. All of us use it every day. However, there's a big difference when a pencil is in our hands or in the hands of Charles Dickens, Ernest Hemingway, or Mark Twain. When the pencil is set apart and is in the hands of a brilliant author, it will leave a mark that will last. God calls us to be holy by being set apart from what is common. And it's not because we are intrinsically superior from the rest of the world, but it is because we are in the hands of God Himself. And when we are in His hands, we can then be used as instruments that will leave a mark. And so what does it mean that we are holy? It means that we line up our lives according to God's plumb line. It means that we love our enemies, even if that is not common or popular. It means that we forgive unconditionally, even if it's not common. It means that we don't tolerate anything that is unjust or unrighteous, even if it's common or popular. Even if we sin at times, we can still be called holy if we surrender ourselves as instrument in God's hand and allow Him to use us as His pencils. If you found this video helpful, please like it and share it with a friend. We will continue this series going through God's attributes, so make sure to subscribe and hit the bell notification so that you will know when the next video comes out. Until next time, see you!